we told you are the leader for tomorrow, is that so? Because you are the leader for the future. That is a lie. So know it from today. Those who lead, they don't start, they don't wait for the future, they lead today. And I was happy when I heard that from the CEO and the Ambassador Amina, knows that for her to be a cabinet secretary, she did not start leading when she was, she started when she was in primary. And there are many, many streams of leadership. You can lead, even the best one is leading yourself. Because as you lead yourself to desirable, well thought decisions. So all of us, we should be able to accept, not wait for tomorrow, as what I said, tomorrow never comes. Two, I thought I needed to come because whenever we speak to a group of people, and we are trying to paint a vision which the president has shared with us, that he wants to see a prosperous, united, cohesive nation. And all of us in the cabinet, we have brought that in our respective dockets. So you see, and of course, this is my alma mater. And also, I had the chair of student leadership with Anede. The president is a champion of the youth and at UN level, and he understands the energy, the resilience, the innovation that the youth of this country bring into the thinking of how this country can have a better quality of life for Kenyans. Because I think the reason why all of us in government struggle is our Kenyans saying they are having a better quality of life because the government is facilitating the environment so that those who are able to do business can have some better economic, socioeconomic status and enjoy a better quality of life. And I'm sure there's a lot which the government has done in making sure the youth, the women, and the general citizens, they are able to enjoy an environment that empowers them to have a better future. We are also, I'm also very happy that the economy of this country, only last week when the economic survey came up, you were informed it has grown by 6.3, about a million jobs. However, we are able to create about 850 jobs, according to the survey last week. We created only 850 jobs. And out of those 850 jobs, 85% of them were from informal sector, small businesses. That means the youth who are intending to be economically empowered, the jobs are found in small and medium enterprises. Where are those jobs? What kind of skills do they require? And I think you remember when Ambassador Amina was in the Ministry of Education, they started the TVET program. And I hope most of you, even as you're in the university, it is even making sense you finish a degree and still go and do a vocation training, which is going to guarantee you the job. Moreover, the majority of the youth, now called digital natives, are increasingly connected to cyberspace. This has exposed them to different cultural, lifestyle, and other influences which collectively form that we call a cyber culture. This space can be both destructive and it can be also beneficial. In fact, we say the whole issue of social media, it is either a tool, it is a very good tool. Either can, the way you use it, it can destroy it or can build. We must reflect carefully on how to create opportunity for the young people and also protect them from undesirable influences. The Ministry of Sport, Culture and Heritage can play an important role in addressing some of these issues surrounding youth in our country. For instance, sports and the arts are a major source of income for the young people. This is a change from the tradition. In the past, young people looked at employment, and we are now finding current development in the area of sports and service industry, making something we can envy as income. Besides the economic opportunity, sports can greatly enrich the individual and the social lives of the youth. At the individual level, the health benefits of sports are scientifically proven, especially with regard to preventing and uncommunicable diseases. We should all remember why the Romans and the Greeks always talked about mens sana in corpo sano, translating a healthy mind is a healthy body. Sports is an essential part of education, particularly the cultivation and inculcation of critical values like respect for the rule of law, teamwork, fair play, and self-confidence. Sports sharpens the individual creative faculties, enhances endurance, and will empower and responsibility. Socially, the application of sports rules as well as the ideals of the creative art advances the agenda of building a better world.
I'm so happy that during my lifetime, there has been a young woman who has been elected president of something. So I'm hoping that finally we'll get to elect a woman to be, you know what? What? There you go. There you go. So our work is not done yet. I think you are the beginning of this journey. And of course, in the middle of the journey is C.S. Margaret Kobia. And we are hoping, you know, that good things will happen in the near future. Because it showed youth taking responsibility for their actions, right? And so I want you to be the ones that will move from peer pressure to peer support. I want you to say that. From peer pressure
to peer support.
Support each other. Don't pressure each other to do the wrong thing. Support each other to do the right thing.